This program is about unsolved mysteries. Whenever possible, the actual family members and police officials have participated in recreating the events. What you are about to see is not a news broadcast. In this episode of Unsolved Mysteries, we feature a mysterious death in a cargo port in the city of Singapore, in which the forensics seems to defy physics and logic. We also go into a Los Angeles area home where a police raid has gone terribly wrong that ends up in a double homicide with suspicion of friendly fire. We also head over into international waters where a mysterious unidentified flying object has been spotted, and it is way different from the rest of the UFOs you've ever seen. We travel over to Pakistan where a murder at a meltdown plant seems to happen, but the forensics don't match up. And lastly, we head into a mysterious disappearance of a wealthy billionaire aboard his yacht. Stay tuned and maybe you can solve a mystery. Our first story is from a cargo port in the city of Singapore, for which forensic scientists are scratching their head trying to piece together the physics that went behind this homicide here. It is presumed that both the victim and the killer were involved in some smuggling of adult beverages, as you see on the cargo crate, over here for extra money on the side. These two rival factions had been going at it for months upon end now, and it culminates in disaster. However, the forensic scientists can't seem to figure out how the blood on the floor from the victim would match with the bullet hole through the head, because in order for it to actually happen, the bullet must have curved around this wall right here. Incredible, folks. If you have any information about this murder, don't hesitate to leave that information down in the comments section. We need your help in trying to solve this mystery. Our next story comes from the city of Los Angeles, in which there is a police raid trying to bust up a multi-million dollar drug smuggling ring. However, this raid went terribly wrong and resulted in a police officer being shot down in cold blood here. Police say that the drug lord had shot and killed the police officer in cold blood, but again, the forensics does not add up, and some of the media are suspicious here of friendly fire. You could clearly see that if it had been the drug lord himself, the bullets that he would have shot did not even come on target at all. As you see, the police officer was clearly not in the line of sight when the drug smuggler did end up taking shots. So this has fueled media speculation of police friendly fire here, and the family's victim just wants answers. If you have any answers to this case, leave them down in the comments section. Our next story is a really strange one, and it comes over international waters as a man on his boat has come face to face with an unidentified flying object. However, it is not like a UFO that you have ever seen before. Most reports of UFOs have been at night with large crafts with bright lights making mysterious moves. This particular unidentified flying object looks more like a vegetable steamer in size, fueling the speculation that aliens might be smaller than they appear, just like things in the rearview mirror. And unfortunately, this alien technology seemed to have been indestructible. We tried normal things like Swiss Army knives and throwing several explosives at it, but the alien craft had no reaction whatsoever. It did not try to duck, dip, dive, and dodge out of the way of these firearms, nor did it even move from the spot it's in. Now, that's leads to people believing aliens. Could they be around on the planet, just not in the form that we know? If you have any information on this UFO craft, please leave it down in the comments section. Our next story comes from a murder at the meltdown plant in Pakistan, right here, where this mysterious man was gunned down in cold blood. However, the physics and forensics do not add up, because the angle that the body had dropped at, plus the bullet trail, leads forensic scientists to believe that this shooter was actually on a head glitch spot over here, when clearly there were barrels and multiple objects in the way, with no exit trace bullets and paths from these particular barrels. So that leads to the question, was there a second shooter? Do police have to be looking for the wrong person? Again, if you have any information on this case, leave it down in the comments section. And our last story here is about a wealthy man on his multi-million dollar yacht who mysteriously ended up disappearing one night after hosting a party for a bunch of guests. Police are suspicious that someone may have poisoned him, as there are some signs of struggle that were found in the dining room with chairs being knocked over. The food has not yet been tested for any signs of any tampering. However, the results should come back soon, and police are very suspicious that this billionaire must have been poisoned, because as you see clearly here, there is no way that he was shot through the wall, as some conspirators like to argue on some internet forums. Police are looking into all angles, though, and are trying to help reach the bottom of this. Now, if you have any information on this or any other case that has been featured tonight, please leave that down in the comments section, and maybe you can help solve a mystery.